What's up, everyone? It's your boy NorinRad89 here, bringing another ranking video. Today we have Suicide Squad, the new one, coming up in August. So today I wanted to stop and rank all the DCEU films that we have so far in the universe. There's 10, including the Justice League Snyder Cut. So this is going to be my personal list from worst to best. That means I would love to hear from all of you in the comments section, because my list isn't the right list. It's just my list. So let's get down to this ranking. Roll it. So we have 10 DCEU films so far, and of course there has to be a bottom one. Number 10 for me is going to be the Justice League 2017 one that was directed by Josh Whedon and finished off by him. It's just not a great film at all. Tonally, completely not what DC represents or anything like that. Like, Josh Whedon came in after Zack Snyder was kicked off of the project, and the executives and him just basically cut apart and took Zack Snyder's movie, chopped out all these unnecessary things that they felt was unnecessary, but ruined the movie and put out this Frankenstein horrible version of it in 2017. And this is definitely the worst DC film for me. Number 9 for me is going to be Wonder Woman 1984. This is definitely a graphics, and it looks beautiful, this film, the way it looks and the design of Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman. But the story, there's so many lapses of logic. I don't like the portrayal of Wonder Woman in this film. It's just, again, another version of a DC film that totally is tonally messed up and doesn't represent what DC is. It definitely feels more like a Marvel style film, and it just doesn't fit the vibe, or Wonder Woman for that matter, at all. I didn't like the villain by Pedro Pascal in this film either. So like I said, Wonder Woman 1984 for me was just a very failed attempt at a good sequel for Wonder Woman. Number 8 for me is going to be Suicide Squad. This is another one that kind of sucks because David Ayer was taken out of the helm of the project as the director, and the executives came in and had a bunch of editors just go into the editing room and chop his film up and try to put together some kind of mashed up version of it, and it really didn't come out that well at all, which kind of sucks because the trailers for this film looked really amazing, and the editors just ended up messing it up and turning it into kind of like a pop video, pop song type movie with a bunch of, you know, sexual references and stuff you just don't want from a Suicide Squad movie. So that's why it's sitting here at this number 8 spot. Number 7 for me is going to be Shazam. This was another DC film that kind of failed at its attempt to please me. I just didn't really like Zachary Levi's portrayal as Shazam. I think Mark Strong is a pretty bad cookie cutter villain in this film. I like the kid cast in this movie, but like basically all the grown-ups in this film I just didn't enjoy. The storyline is just not that interesting enough, and the battle at the end with all like Shazam and his friends, and he gives them powers and they fight like Mark Strong, like, it just, I didn't enjoy it. Like, that whole third act to me is just a complete mess. So that's why Shazam is sitting here at this number 7 spot. Number 6 for me is going to be Birds of Prey. And from here on up, all these DC films I do enjoy and I like. Those other ones I would actively try to avoid. But Birds of Prey, I saw this in theaters and this was a really good time for sure. This movie is a blast. It has Harley Quinn as this unreliable narrator throughout the film. There's an amazing cast of sexy ladies coupled with this great villain played by Ewan McGregor. He does a great version of Black Mask in this film. I thought Birds of Prey was a great breath of fresh air, especially in the DC films for sure. Now we're here at the top 5, and if you haven't yet, drop a like and hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date on all the content that I put out. So let's kick it off with my number 5 choice. My number 5 film is going to be Wonder Woman. This was a great introduction to Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman of her own film. And when this film first came out in the trailers, I wasn't really one of those people that was like, oh, I need to see this, it's going to be amazing. I kind of had my skepticisms. But then when I saw the movie, it's such a great movie for sure. Her and Chris Pine have an amazing chemistry on screen, and it's just a really good epic story of Wonder Woman and a good kind of origin backstory for her. And I really did enjoy the way they tackled this film and executed it and brought it to life for all of us to see. Number four for me is going to be the Aquaman film, directed by James Wan. He did such an amazing job with this film. It is epic in every facet of that word. It looks beautiful on scale of production value. It is such a high production value film. Like I said, it's colorful. It's got an amazing cast. And like I said, Jason Momoa, I think, was kind of born to be the Aquaman that we needed for this generation, you know what I mean? For this DC universe, he really does fit the role so well. And like I said, this was a great film. I am so excited for Aquaman 2. I can't wait till that film comes out. And like I said, I hope they just keep going on with a lot of that crazy, colorful style and epic, you know, storytelling, almost like a Shakespearean type soap opera play, you know what I mean? That's kind of how this one felt, and like how epic and how serious it was and everything, and they tackled it so amazingly. So number four, Aquaman, sitting here very comfortable. And now my number three pick for the DC films is going to be the most recent one, the Justice League Snyder Cut. Oh my God, this was such an amazing film. Even though it's 4 hours long, everything that Zack Snyder decided to do for this film and include in it, and it was so much of an improvement compared to that 2017 one. And I'm so happy that we got to see Zack Snyder really relive his vision on screen and present it to us, because this film is what I wanted from a Justice League movie in the first place. It has such amazing storytelling. It's so gripping. It looks amazing. The music is on point. Like I said, Zack Snyder really did take this film, treat it almost like his baby, and just brought to life the most amazing kind of Justice League film that I really did enjoy. I had a blast with all the 4 hours of this film. And number two for me, the runner-up to the top dog, is going to be Man of Steel. I'm not a huge Superman fan, but I easily can tell you that this is the best version of Superman that I think we've gotten on live action by far. Zack Snyder found a way to make Superman so much more realistic and grounded in a real world aspect, and Henry Cavill does an amazing job portraying Clark Kent and Superman. Oh, this is such an amazing film. Like I said, Kevin Costner as his father, Russell Crowe in this film. The cast is top notch. Diane Lane in this film. Like, it's just such an amazing cast. And we have such a great director at the helm of this project, and Zack Snyder, like, just to see his vision of what he was trying to do with the films when Man of Steel first came out, it was just, I knew we were going to be in for something really, really epic, because Zack Snyder, like I said, he's such a great visual storyteller, and like I said, I'm not a huge fan of Superman, so I wasn't expecting to really like this film. And Man of Steel for me is a hardcore rewatch. I do highly enjoy this film. The score is one of the best scores for any film of anything that we've ever had. So this is, like I said, this is a really good film. No doubt, like I said, Zack Snyder brought it to life. And it's just one of my hardcore rewatches. I really do like Man of Steel, sitting here at number two. And number one for me, the top dog, is going to be Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice. Oh, man, this movie, when I saw the trailers for this film, I was so excited. I was happy that Zack Snyder was able to take stuff from the Dark Knight graphic novel and really kind of took influence from that and bring to life, like, I think, the best version that we're ever going to get of live action of Batman versus Superman. This is the best version we're ever going to have. Even if they tackle it years and years from now, I still don't think they're going to do it better than this. I know some people and some fans have problems with the plot holes in this film. Some people don't like Ben Affleck as Batman, but I can tell you right now, Ben Affleck's Batman is the perfect version of Batman to go up against Henry Cavill's version of Superman. Like, it was just the perfect cameos to go against each other. Their chemistry was amazing. As you can see, I have this poster right here. Batman v Superman is a hardcore rewatch for me. It's just so gripping, so emotional. I love the storytelling, and it really did for me take the DCEU films and elevate them in a way where I was like, oh, this is amazing. Like, for me, Warner Brothers and DC, they should have just handed Zack Snyder the keys and told him and gave him all the money he wanted and told him to run with it. After he did Man of Steel and Batman v Superman, they should have gave him all the money and all the keys and everything. Like I said, just create it. Do this world for us, because Zack Snyder really does love these characters, and you can tell. And there is a Batman v Superman. There's a theatrical version that I even saw that in theaters, and the theatrical version is good too. I do like that version. But there's an Ultimate Edition on the DVD that has about, I think, 20 to 30 minutes of extra footage, and it does a lot better in making the Batman v Superman story more cohesive, gives you a lot more things in the film. Even the lines and stuff are better. So I recommend checking out that version of the film. That's the best version for sure. But for me, Man of Steel and Batman v Superman, those are the two that I was tussling with. Like, which one's going to be the top one? Because Man of Steel really surprised me. It was such a great portrayal of the Clark Kent storyline and everything. And Batman v Superman, I just loved seeing them battle on screen for the first time. You see Gal Gadot's introduction of Wonder Woman in this film. Like, oh, it's so good. Like, I even do like Jesse Eisenberg as Lex Luthor. I think he's very witty, very smart. He brought something new to the Lex Luthor role that we've never seen before. So that's why I settled with Batman v Superman as my number one. That's my top dog. I hope you guys enjoyed this ranking video. As I said, share your list down below. I would love to hear from all of you. And thanks for sticking around with me, y'all. Have a safe and happy day. Peace out.